This is the practice video for you ukulele players for Hey Jude. And yes, your violin teacher has a ukulele, okay? Thank you to Mr. Shriver for letting me borrow this so I can mess around with it. I've never actually played a ukulele before today. And so I'm gonna show you what the different chords are for Hey Jude and what the finger pattern is. And then we'll try to do a play along because I think a lot of you just need to be able to see the finger patterns while the song is going, okay? So here are the chords. If you click in the description of this video, there should be a link to the tabs, the ukulele tabs that you can look, and the order of the chords along with the words to the song. So please click on that. You should probably have that up while we're doing this. I have mine up on my screen here too, so I don't make a mistake. So our first chord for the verse, Hey Jude, is A major. So we have, I'm gonna just do the strings as 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Because the pitches make it not easy to say high or low. So you want second finger on the first string here on the second fret, first finger on the second string on the first fret, and that is A major. We play that one a lot, okay? Then there are two options for E major. That's going to be our next chord in the verse here. So here's the first version. You can put your first finger on the first fret on the first string. You can put your second finger on the second fret on the fourth string, and then pinky here on the fourth fret on the second string. Okay. Your second or your middle two strings should sound the same. Okay. So that might be hard for your pinky, but sometimes this actually works out with some of the progressions we have to do a little bit later on in the song. So that's option number one. Option number two is to put first finger on the second fret on the fourth string here, and then shove 2, 3, and 4 on the fourth frets, or on the fourth fret on the other strings. So that might be easier for some of you. It's kind of nice because you can put your first finger down and just kind of slam onto the fourth fret. Just target practice for the fourth fret and you've got it, okay? What else do we have? We have an E7. This chord is optional. If you have too much trouble trying to do an E7 in the progression, don't worry about it. You can just play E major, whichever one that you want, okay? But E7 is first string, first fret, first finger, second string, second fret, second finger. And you can put your third finger on the second fret on the fourth string. Makes it sound pretty, okay? So far we've had A, E, this is E7, and then D major is the second fret on the low three strings. Okay, so you might wanna do 1, 2, 3. On string 1, 2, 3 on the second fret. I like to do second finger, third finger, and fourth finger just because we're gonna go to A a lot, back and forth between D and A, and that means I don't have to move my second finger. Check that out, guys. I'm moving my monkey swing. Monkey swing for ukulele too, see? It's no joke, you gotta move it, okay? So that's D major. 2, 3, and 4, or 1, 2, and 3 on the second fret on the low three strings, or the strings 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so those are all the chords for the verse. Then we get to the bridge. And anytime you feel the pain, that part. So our first chord for that is A7. All we have to do is put our first finger on the first fret on the second string. Okay, that's it. Then we have D major again, A major again. Then we have B minor. So you can cheat a little bit here. That's what I'm doing right now. It might not sound good when I put all this together, but put your first finger and bar it on the second, third, and fourth string on the second fret. And then you're gonna put, let's see, third finger. Yes, third finger on the fourth fret on the first string. If you're having trouble barring and you're getting a weird buzz, you can use your middle finger to help push down your first finger to bar it. Okay, that's what it should sound like. Okay, that's B minor. Then we'll go back to D major. then E major, then A major. Those are all the same as we learned before. The second time through this part, because we have, remember in the violin part, we have da 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 at the end there. So the chords for that, da da da, G major. That's the only new one here. Okay, so it's first finger, second fret, second string, third finger, third fret, third string, and then second finger, second fret, fourth string, G major. Back to E major. Okay, and then we go back to the verse. Nothing different in the verse. We will not play during the nasty part in the violin. Violin breakdown section there before the chorus here. So, da 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 dee, da da da. Okay. So nothing new in here for the chorus. It's just A major. Da. Okay. Then you're gonna go to G major. Then D major. Back to A major. See that? You can see why I want to do the 2-3-4 there, because I'm gonna go back and forth between D. So A, G, D, then back to A. That's it. Those are all the chords. If you're having trouble with any of them, just let me know, and I'll see if I can find an easier way to do some of them. The B minor is a pain for sure, and what you could do is just bar your first finger and just play the top three strings and not worry about the low one, okay? So I'm gonna play the recording that has the piano and the violin part and see if this works so you can see. All right, here we go, A major. Repeat. that's with the recording. Here's another option I just thought of. If you're having trouble making it from chord to chord, like for instance, right at the beginning, hey, da-da-da-da, you can come in on the second beat because you have da, one, two, three, and four, and one, two, three. Don't be afraid to just miss out on a beat. It's totally fine. So if I were to miss out, I'll try it again here. Hey, da 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 da. If that makes sense, so you can give yourself just some lag time. You have a whole beat in order to make sure you have your finger pattern. Okay, some options there. Hopefully that helps. I'm sorry that I didn't play everything that well, but hopefully you can see. And again, come to class with your questions if you have any. And most importantly, have fun. All right. Good luck, guys.